Hi, welcome back to Answering ATPL. In this ATPL question bank video series for general navigation subject, I am going to show you how to answer this convergency question. First, I will illustrate the question and later we will solve the problem using the appropriate formula. And we are starting right now. The focus of this channel is to provide explanation for ESA ATPL examination and other aviation related stuff. If this is your first time here, consider subscribing to Answering ATPL by clicking the subscribe button and click on the bell icon to get notified when I publish a new video. The following waypoints are entered into an inertial navigation system, INS. Waypoint 1, 60 degree north, 30 degree west. Waypoint 2, 60 degree north, 20 degree west. Waypoint 3, 60 degree north, 10 degree west. The inertial navigation is connected to the autopilot on route waypoint 1, waypoint 2, waypoint 3. The track change on passing waypoint 2 will be approximately. The optional answer are A, a 4 degree decrease, B, a 9 degree decrease, C, 0, and D, a 9 degree increase. The best way to answer this type of question is to illustrate it first. By illustrating the question, we can visualize and figure the way to solve it. Here is the data given by the question. Next, we need to draw the relevant longitude. 30 degree west, 20 degree west and 10 degree west. As you can see, this three line is converging at the top. The reason why this three line converging at the top is that the location referred by the question is in the northern hemisphere. If you look at this picture taken from Google Earth, all the longitude in the northern hemisphere is converging toward the North Pole. Next, we need to draw the latitude 60 degree north. The drawing convention is, for northern hemisphere, latitude lines are concave toward the North Pole. And here is waypoint 1, 60 degree north, 30 degree west. Waypoint 2, 60 degree north, 20 degree west. And waypoint 3, 60 degree north, 10 degree west. As the question stated, the waypoints are entered into an inertial navigation system and connected to the autopilot. That means that the aircraft will fly along the great circle. Great circle track is the shortest distance between two positions. The blue line marks the great circle track from waypoint 1 to waypoint 2, and the yellow line marks the great circle track from waypoint 2 to waypoint 3. We need to find the track change on passing waypoint 2. Let me simulate the situation. The aircraft on the screen will follow the great circle track from waypoint 1 to waypoint 3. We need to find the heading change here. If the aircraft travel from waypoint 1 to waypoint 3 along the latitude, it will fly a Rhumb line track. The heading that it will fly along the latitude is 090 degree. If you want to learn more about great circle and Rhumb line, please check my other video titled Great Circle, Small Circle, Rhumb line, Convergency and Conversion Angle. I will put the link in the description. I highly recommend you check out the video. Now we will put back the aircraft track on the diagram. As you can see, there is an angle between the great circle track and Rhumb line track. This angle is known as the conversion angle. Because the track maintains the same latitude and the longitude change between waypoint 1 and 2 and waypoint 2 and 3 are the same, all the conversion angle in this diagram will have equal value. The question asks us to find the heading change at waypoint 2. The heading change is the difference between these two angles. The heading change of these two angles is the same as 2 times conversion angle. Now, we will start the calculation step. Heading change equal 2 times conversion angle. The formula for conversion angle is conversion angle equal half convergency. Conversion angle equal half change of longitude time sine latitude. Conversion angle equal to half time. For change of longitude, we can take either leg because the value will be the same. I will take 30 minus 20 time sine 60. Conversion angle equal 4.33 degree. Heading change is 2 times conversion angle. Thus, heading change equals 8.66 degree. The closest answer is 9 degree. But we have two options for 9 degree. Option B decreases and option D is increased. If you remember, from our animation, the aircraft is making a left-hand turn at waypoint 2. In aviation, when you are turning left, the heading will always decrease. Thus, the answer is B. What do you think of this video? Please let me know in the comment section below. And if you find the video beneficial, please like it and share with others. By doing so, you will help other people find the video. If you want to learn more about ATPL or other aviation related stuff, subscribe now by clicking the round subscribe icon. Please check out my other video by clicking on the rectangular box. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time.